Hello folks, I decided to do AI stuff as soon as possible. Multiple people asked me. There is only one, in my opinion, there's only one key AI script that you need. I'm going to show you how to make it. AI is my weakness. It's not something I know very well. If you want detailed information, it's on Discord, maybe Reddit, but certainly Discord is a gold mine for AI information and pre-made AI script. You can do some magic with this. I do have a cough for some reason, so if you hear silent moments, it's because I'm muting my mic. I am commenting on the spot. So let's create an active module. I have five active modules in my tower testing, and I want it to run automatically. I don't want to have to click, of course. So I survived. I mean, I made it all the way in my main save file with only this. That's the first part of the video. Second part, I messed around with three scripts that run the mine all together as a team. I'll show you that. And a little one for arcade, just for examples. It's something you can play around with. If you're good at programming, it's a bonus. So let's say I want to make a script. So you go new. Let's call it active 2. I don't know what package is. There's a lot of things I don't know. I'm just going to show you the simple stuff again. I kept it simple in the first run. I figured it out on my own. It's not rocket science for the basic stuff, but it can become very complicated. You go edit to add some commands. There we go here. Now, if you hit F4, you have your AI overlay. This is where you'll be able to activate certain AI scripts. If you hit F2, it's the debug. I found this by looking at the key mapping by accident. If I move my mouse, you see on the top right, mouse position. So if you want to find out your mouse position, the mouse position of a button, and you want to make a script where it clicks at a certain position, for instance, you can use that. On the left, there's information, but I don't understand it. And that's not something I'll ever use because I'm never going to push AI. I don't have time and I don't need to. It's really a thing for fun and for quality of life. It can be quite powerful, but it's not essential. I'm just going to show you what's essential. So let's turn that off. First, you need to activate your AI. Multiple ways to do this. We're going to look at wake up, but I prefer using a key. But also some condition. You can open, let's say I open the arcade, activate the script, my arcade script. I have a mine script, three of them. But the problem is every time I open a mine, it creates a new duplicate. I prefer using a key. A number, well, when you type in numbers, if your overlay is on, I had a trouble where it would create duplicates of my, I'll show you what I mean by that. Let's try wake up just so I can show you what wake up does, then we'll switch to what I actually use. So wake up is every time I activate my overlay, it will activate my script. So let's go with wake up for now. You can add conditions. I don't know how that works, so you will have to do your own research on this. Sorry, I cannot give you much, but I'll give you again, the absolute basic essential. So these, I'm under the impression, by the way, and I want to talk about the number of action. I'm under the impression, well, maybe I heard some of it vaguely that it has to do with this, but I don't understand. And apparently it's not essential. And I don't know how to, please don't tell me. To check on Discord. I don't know how this works, but it's related, okay? When you go in technology, if you upgrade your RAM, you have more lines in your scripts. Let's go back. I misclicked. Exit. So, to activate modules, you go tower, use instantly. I have five active modules. So there are five slots. So slot 1, then you go 2. Now I could, like this. If you right click, it copies it. It's a little faster. 3. 4. Whoops. Here. 5. Now if I activate this, it will go 1, 3, 4, 5 and stop. I want it to loop. So you go with go to. where are you? Go to. There's also go to if, so you can add a condition, but let's not go there. Go to line one at the end. Line one is here, the number is here. So it's gonna go like this, go to line one, and like that. So let's say I have this. It says when you hit X, now it's saved, I close. If I hit F4, you see active two is on, that's because I have the wake up thing, but that's not what I want. So let's change it. I'm gonna delete this. You can have multiple impulses, but I don't know how that works. I suppose you would have multiple conditions for your script to get started. I don't know. I don't want to speculate too much. Now let's use key A. I know WASD makes you move in the town, but I don't care. A is fine. So in this case, all my scripts use A, by the way. So if I go F4, I hit A. I got arcade, my mind stuff, I'll show you that, and active too, the one we're interested in. Okay. But yeah, if I hit A again, see, it creates duplicates and it makes me move around. And you can create duplicates, but I want to avoid that, I suppose. It doesn't lag. I don't know how long it would take for it to lag. Okay, so let's activate this. Then I don't want to activate yet. Oops, F4. You go F4 to just stop everything. I don't know if there's a way to make it stop. So by the way, I'm empty 15, so things will be out of place. Ignore that. I'm way ahead of the actual footage in the series where I'm about to show you error. I recorded everything, but there's a long task. If it takes time and I'm busy, so there's a long task at empty 15 that you have to do, and I'll make a video about that when the time is right. It already exists in the old series, but it will be updated. But I want to tell you, just in case you want to avoid spoilers. But it takes a while to do anyway, so I'm doing it slowly as I'm catching up to MT-15. So again, you'll see high numbers, but ignore that. So if I go launch, okay, these are my, you know, if you go skills here, these are my skills, my active muscles, but they're not working. Not automatically, I can click like this. Right, but that's not what I want. I want it to be automated. If I go A, look, they're all active. And it's very important because Super Tower 2 and 3, well, all of them, I really like those a lot, those active muscles. They are very strong active muscles. In fact, I think they are essential active muscles. And I didn't build, I'm building two blueprints right now for whatever task I'm talking about in MT-15. But the main ultimate blueprint where I'll push real hard is not ready yet at all, because I'm not there in the game yet. So that's it for this part, okay? So important, you must make it. You must make this, in my opinion. Otherwise, you cannot use active muscles, or you play by hand. A lot of pain. That's why this video is so important. But then I can go a little further and show you a little more advanced stuff, which is not, well, it's not that impressive, but maybe the mine is not too bad. I made one for arcade back then because I did not have enough workers. I don't use it anymore. In fact, the mine, I'll delete this and reactivate this. So you enable, save. It's the same. I just made a new one to show you how to create one. So arcade, spin the lucky wheel. So impulse key, the same thing. Spin the lucky wheel. So it's all in the actions here. Spin the lucky wheel with a wager of whatever. Start jumble with a wager of whatever. But when you do jumble, you also have to hit stop. And you go back to line one and it goes like this. But for it to work, the mine in arcade, for instance, you have to be there physically. So if I go in the arcade, no, I just turned off the overlay, I can't turn it on. If I go A, it's gonna start running both of them all at once. So at one point I needed to do this. Again, I did not have enough workers and I left arcade open. Especially Lucky Wheel, early in the game, it's easy to get cards. But Jumble takes longer, it's more expensive. In fact, look, I don't even have them. I mean, T15, I don't even have them all. But I don't have any worker that do a jumbo, and I have a lot of cash right now. But anyways, so that's a simple one. And I just sit there and it runs by itself with an AI, not workers. Now the mine, I want it to be a bit fancy with the mine. I almost click on it. I don't want to yet. In fact, I'll turn that off. The mine, I decided to have fun with it because at the very beginning, I wanted to... okay, first of all, why is there left and right? It's because I did not have enough lines to make a full script for the mine. But then I changed my mind and I kept left and right. I'll explain why. So I have three modules running at once all on the mine to automate it completely. There are better ways to do it. Because I saw a video, I don't know how the person did it. It's faster than me. It doesn't matter because I catch up. So how did I build this? I'm gonna show it to you. That's a bonus thing, okay? So there's coordinates. There's 16 tiles and there's coordinate. So X and Y. So I started on that's the two first left columns. And there's from top to bottom. So that's the first one. Now, why is there a delay? That's because you know how if I go in the mine and you know, I do this, whatever, I have to click on this button. And there's also tabs. So how do I do this in the AI? Well, I found a way. You'll see it gets fast, but not at the beginning. You'll see what I mean. Edit. Well, it's relatively fast right away, but it gets crazy after edit. So I'm going to wait just a little bit. I'm going to generate a new layer in the mine because I just did everything. So this is the left side. I'm going to show you the right side, but I'm waiting just a little bit to make sure that the right side is done. I don't know if I need this, but it seemed off. It was a bit fast. I was like, ah. So what I'll do is I'll wait just a tiny bit to give time to the other script to end, to make sure the whole map is, the whole 16 things are dug up. And then I'll generate a new layer, go to line one, rinse and repeat. So that's the left side. I see 11 actions, right? Again, now I have 25. I made one where all the tiles are being mined. But I realized that if I have two scripts running at once, the left and the right, I mine two squares at a time. It's faster. Maybe I can make four scripts, maybe four, even 16 scripts, right? I make 16 scripts and all 16 are mined all at once, but it's not needed. You'll see why if you let it run long enough. I don't use this anymore, but it doesn't matter. The right side, now that's the third column, fourth column, and from top to bottom. But this one does not generate layer because if I was to do that, I would lose two layers at a time because I have two scripts running. Only one script does the layer thing. Okay. How about the tab? How do I do the tab? Mine tab. Go to tab one. Wait while mine has layer is true. Now, what I wanted originally, and I don't know, maybe you can help me. I would be interested in the comments. I wanted to go to tab one and wait until mine as layer is false. Because there's wait until. Is it, it's not alphabetical? Just give me a moment, I'll find it. Here, wait until. But there's no negative. So if I go, there's no space. Oh no, look, I just removed this. It's easy to make. Wait until. Hold on. Wait until what? Mine has layer, but I wanted a negative. Wait until mine no longer has layer. So there's no not condition, but I don't know. That's what I think. I didn't find it. So I found a way to do it anyways, and let's just recreate or go through line one. There you go. So instead I was thinking, I said, okay, wait while the mine has layer is true. And then while it's true, and then eventually it's no longer true. When there's no more layer, I'm gonna go to the next tab and so on. So all three modules work together to do. I'm gonna show you what it does. It starts a bit slow, but you'll see it's fast. See, I have 28 layers right now. MT15 again, don't forget that. So F4, A, and now I'm gonna mine like this every single tab. It's not that fast yet. Again, if I had 16 scripts running, all 16, bang, 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 will all be mined at once. But there's no rush, because if I'm going to do this, which I don't anymore, eventually, there's not enough time for layers to be generated, and things become extremely fast and it just flashes. So as we wait for this to flash, what I want to tell you is, once again, if you want to push hard on AI, you can, if you're a programmer, you're probably going to find this not too bad. Or you can do research on Discord, maybe Reddit, or maybe the wiki. My knowledge is extremely limited. But if there's one that you need, is the Active Muzzle AI script. I'm convinced you absolutely need it. I don't see any way without it. To really make a good blueprint, there are key active modules. And that's what I have for you, but I'm gonna just let it run because you're gonna see it go fast. See, now it's a little bit faster because there's less layers, and eventually there'll be only like one layer per tab. Now it's a little fast. See, now it's flashing, right? So it's fast enough. I don't need all the 16 scripts. Look at this thing. So it's running super fast now, and I can let it run for hours. But I don't use it anymore, as I said, because I'm using workers. The reason why I'm using workers is when I do battle drills, triple the speed at which new mining layers are generated while tower testing is active. So I do tower testing. I already talked about this, I think, last episode. I do tower testing. Then I get more, and even geology, I get more gems. I'm trying to get blue gems. Does this do anything? Yeah, there's a chance for an exotic gem too. So I'd rather have workers do it while I'm doing tower testing than just this running. I don't think it's significant amounts that I get in terms of blue gems. So I no longer use it, but I wanted to show it to you. I was all proud to do this on my own, like a big boy, you know. But that's as far as I'm gonna get in AI. I wish I could give you more advanced stuff, but again, it's my weakness. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please hit thumbs up and leave a comment below. If you want to support this channel, you can subscribe and hit the notification bell to make sure you don't miss future videos. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.